Hello, everybody, and welcome back for another episode of What's the Doctor Doing Today? Well, I have to say that the new after the Skyblock reset, we have done a lot. We have a new island team. So we have a team of guys building, and it's looking pretty good. We're still sort of a freeform island. We've got a few cool things about it, but that's not what this one is about. This is an update video regarding the follow-ups from my two previous features for the item filter and the hopper filter features. Now, I've waited a few weeks to do this one because there was a bug with since the reset. There was a bug with the features that you couldn't add new filters after a certain time. So you couldn't add new filter profiles, rather, I should say. So now that's all fixed. So let's go over this. So let's come back over here. I am still running my standard one, which I called junk before, which just to go back and show you again. I just have that one set up in just one hopper filter profile, but you can have several. You can only still run one at a time, but that's okay. So I selected that, and then I'll just go ahead and set up a new one right now for you guys. So let's select, and I'll just do junk 2. All right, that's a valid name, so we set that. Now let's select another one here. So let's go ahead and just click the poppies as the icon. So now let's load it. Let's come back. And now we go through and we would say that we don't want any lapis. We don't want coal. Or we're gonna select and add these. Rather, you're not saying whether you do or don't want them yet. So we don't want the lapis or the coal. We don't want poppies. And we don't want cobble or iron blocks. And we go back. Okay, so right now this is set to white filter, so let's turn to blacklist, which means that all the items that are selected in this filter, we do not want. So there we go. We're now blocking all the items that we put on. And so that's where it's at. That's actually just exactly the same as the one I had there. So we'll just leave it there for now. But that one still works. Now and just like before, the item filter. This one is for the items that you, when you're walking around, that you will or will not pick up. So I have a filter set here. I'll go ahead and select another one. I have one set up for mob farming. So when I'm at a zombie pigman farm, I turn this on, and then I only pick up the items on my whitelist, which is just the gold items that I want. And specifically, so because you can't discard, just like I said before, you can't discard damaged items very well. You can't select them here and then have a damaged item match it up on the filter. So in other words, you have to make a whitelist filter. So I only pick up the gold nuggets and the gold ingots. So those are the only two that I set up. So I don't pick up anything else when I go to a zombie pigman farm. But like I said, you can have several of these set up. So whatever kind of farm you want to use for a while, just set up a filter, a whitelist filter for the items you do want, and then you'll discard everything else. So it works pretty good. All right. Remember whitelist, blacklist, you know, the whitelist like that means that the items that are selected in your filter down here are the ones that are going to pass through the filter, and you'll pick those up. When they're blacklist, you're telling you the items you selected you want to reject. So just a little refresher there. But that's it for that one. So those features are the same. Those are working. Like I said, there was a bug before about how they worked when they were first after the reset, but now that's all fixed. The biggest benefit is when you set one of these hopper filters, it does not go away at a server reboot. So you can go through and you can set it up and forget about it. I'll show you what I've done. We built a nice little iron golem farm down here. I'll just show you real quick. We built this little iron golem farm. It's not a big one. They're a lot bigger out there, but it's good enough for us. And so with the filter set, I set that up before we even built it. And I can tell you that I've never, ever gone down and cleaned out poppies from the chest down here. Not once. So just come over and show you. I'll just show you the chests that are mine here. I've never once cleaned out a poppy from any one of these chests. It's beautiful. It's a beautiful thing. So it just sits there and it just stays there. And it's full of iron always. And I never have to come through and clean them out as a chore. So that's just one little thing. I just to give you guys a quick update. Just to tease a couple things coming up here, I'm going to show you over here. You know, you're all familiar with my cobble gen and how much I like that and my design here, which is really awesome. With the hopper filters, I get nothing but the stuff that I want. But you know, I'm not alone. I have island mates, but I have somebody else I want you to take a look at here. This guy is going to need his own little feature video. Hey, buddy. There's my minion. I actually have another one, too. I built this little room here for him, which is just a special little cobble gen just for these guys. So he just sits here, and he's happy to work and work and work away. I'll show you a little trick. Watch this, guys. Look at his inventory. I filled it up, and he stacked it up with diamonds and emeralds for me. Isn't that great? Good boy. Good boy. Okay. Just to show you that the hopper filters are working great, let's go down to where we collect down here for these guys. Okay, these are the chests that I collect in from the minion cobble gen. And take a look here. So I already cleaned out a lot of the stuff, but just look at this. It's just getting emeralds, diamonds, redstone, and gold. All right, so this is nothing special. You've seen me do this before. You probably, if you come to my island, you've seen this before. So that's really not a, come visit it, take a look at it. If you want to build one just like it, go for it. Also over here, I have two conspicuously labeled chests down here. One for gold. Oh, Forge Master coming in an hour and a half. And gold. These two chests here, feed the beast. I'll do another video on this, but this is a massive, let me just do a quick little shortcut. Okay. This down here is the beast. This is my gold smeltery. And I can tell you that when you get it running, it produces so many island levels for you. I just stack it full of gold. All the gold ore that comes out of that, I shove it in those, in that chest over there on the end. And out comes gold ingots into here. And the more you stuff in it, the faster it goes until all 12 of these furnaces are lit. It's automatic. It dispenses back in these chests. I use the slash block command to load it up. But look at this. I mean, you wonder how I have 100,000 island levels. This is how, right here. So you can see, this goes on and on and on. This is probably close to 500,000 island levels in what would go into that chest. So those are not nearly all full, just being honest with you there. All right. So this thing probably deserves a feature video on its own as well, the beast. So I look forward to those, and I will be seeing you guys soon. Thanks. Have a good one.